In this lesson, we're going to take a look at how the Google search engine works. Let's begin by understanding what search engines are all about. The job of a search engine is to provide the most relevant answer to a search query. And to understand how search engines do this, we need to look at how they build their index or database. The three key functions involved in this process are crawling, indexing, and ranking. During the crawling process, search engines scour the web for new content. They do this via web crawlers or spiders. When spiders find your web page, they crawl over the code and take note of things like your title, headings, and content. The indexing process is when spiders organize and store information about your page in the search engine's database, known as the index. And the ranking process is when a search engine fetches your page from the index in response to a search query. Pages are typically ranked in order of relevancy from most relevant to least relevant. Now let's take a look at Google's crawling process, and do bookmark this section for your reference. Generally, Google prefers fresh content. So if you have a blog, publishing content regularly can help. If your blog is in a niche that changes rapidly, like technology, then updating that content and publishing new content can really help with ranking. If, on the other hand, you're in a space that doesn't change very much, like literature or history, your ability to rank will depend more on the authority of your page. This brings us to backlinks. High-quality links can help search engines find your content and can sometimes be seen as a vote for your content from other websites, especially when those websites have more authority and trust than your own. And that can give your rankings a boost. And finally, having a well-thought-out internal linking structure and navigation can help Google find relevant pages on your website. Now, in order to get the most out of Google indexing our content, we need to have a few things in place. Things like having a sitemap and using a robots text file, using dofollow and nofollow tags to prevent search engines from indexing certain pages like your contact page or your privacy policy. Taking care of crawling errors caused by missing pages, like the well-known 404 error when you click a link to a page that no longer exists. And setting up redirects where appropriate. Now let's take a look at Google's index. Google's index essentially is a database where it stores information about pages it knows about. Think of this as Google keeping a snapshot of the web and updating it each time it discovers new or updated content. So when you publish a new piece of content, that content is on the web, but search engines don't yet know about it. Therefore, you won't find that page by doing searches online. You can only reach that content by typing in the direct URL or address into a browser. How long Google takes to rank your content depends on a few things. Generally, it can take anything between 4 days and 6 months. And sometimes your content won't get indexed at all if it's poor or you have issues with your domain. Here's a rule of thumb that you can follow. Every time you publish content, you should ask yourself, is this adding value to the web? In other words, make it worth indexing. And here's another tip, do post a few links back to your content on high authority websites like Twitter and Facebook. Google indexes those sites almost continually. So this is one way to ensure that web crawlers find your link and follow it to your content and, all things being well, index it. Now, Google's algorithm is secret, complex, and it keeps evolving. But luckily for us, the SEO community is always hard at work testing, trying to figure out what that ranking criteria is. And so far, we know of around 200 factors. I recommend you bookmark this next section for your reference. So here are some of the most well-known factors categorized. Domain factors, things like age of your domain name, its history, and its authority. Page level factors, things like the title tag and any keywords used in the title and throughout the content. Site level factors, things like the presence of a contact us page and having the right policies in place to make it a trustworthy site. Backlink factors, things like the number of domains linking to your site and the trust factor of the linking pages. User interaction factors, things like the time a user spends on your page and how many of your visitors click a different search result after visiting your page, which would indicate they didn't find the answer they wanted on your page. There are more categories, of course, and some of them have 60 or more proven ranking factors in them. And while these are all important, it can seem a little bit overwhelming, especially if you're just getting started in SEO. So here's another rule of thumb you can follow. Each time you post content, ask yourself, would I trust this website? Does the content answer my question fully, or do I now need to go searching for more information? And is it well written and engaging? For example, you wouldn't or shouldn't buy from an e-commerce website without SSL. You wouldn't trust a business website without a phone number or a contact us page. And you wouldn't trust content that looked like it was written in 5 minutes with the sole intention of selling you something. So apply the same mindset and criteria to your own website and content, and you'll be off to a good start. Remember, Google is all about the user experience, your site authority, and the quality of your content. Now, generally, all competitors on page one have taken care of these factors. That's why they're on page one. So once you've taken care of those factors, what can you do to beat the competition to get the edge on them? Well, it starts with your content. You need to provide relevant and valuable content. And in order to do that, we need to understand the user's search and intent really well. And we can do this with a process known as keyword research. And that's what we're covering next. So I'll see you in the next lesson.